Yo, what is up, my rebels? Today we're gonna break it down how to do a nasty crossface cradle. This is a really great move and it works on all types of levels, not just junior high, middle school, or high school. Junior high and middle school are the same level. But yeah, you get my point. It works in college as well. You see guys like Bo Nickel doing it. But yeah, let's try to break it down in this video. It's a really good crossface here. Yeah, let's break it down. So first step, you really gotta have a nasty crossface. As you see, wrestler in white, nasty crossface. And if you're a wrestler, you know, when you crossface someone, you can literally do anything you want. You can be as hard as you want. It's kind of like punching someone. You just bop them. It's like a hook in boxing or something. Like, you can really hurt them and it's very uncomfortable. And as long as you're not winding up, you can go as hard as you want and it's perfectly legal. So yeah, first step, hard crossface. It's what's gonna get them real uncomfortable. From there, pry up on that crossface. If you see the wrestler in green, it's like making a really weird face, but yeah, it really sucks and it's really uncomfortable. You see his second hand is going through the legs to stop him from circling out, as you see right there. Hand between the legs, stop it from circling out, and then he's gonna bring them together. So right there, starts walking the head to the legs, walking the head to the hands, and then he's gonna lock it up right here. And then next, you gotta try to go on to the other side, jump sides, and that's what's gonna let you finish the move. You wanna be on the same side as your hands are on. So his hands are on the left side, jump sides to the left side. And from there, you finish using the rock back finish. Got his hands locked, he's chilling here, and then pushes his knee forward and takes his opponent straight backwards. But yeah, just like that, easy back points. This works on a lot of levels, and that is a really good crossface cradle right there. A good finish as well, knee in the ribs. This really hurts, knee in the ribs. It's very important and it's really gonna hurt the ribs. But the harder, more painful you make it, the more easier you're gonna get the pin. And also it's kicking that leg up so his opponent can't bridge with that leg. So really good finish from the wrestler in white here. And from here, there's not much you can do as a defensive wrestler other than trying to kick out maybe or bridging, but it's not much you can do. I finally get stopped because potentially dangerous guy can't breathe. But yeah, really good crossface cradle right there. And later in the match, we're going to see one more cradle, which we are going to break down as well. So really good cradles by this guy. He uses rock back finish. Most common finish in crossface cradles is rocking back. So yeah, might do a video on future or different variations in the future, but we'll see about that. So let's break down this one right here. So first off, nasty crossface. As always, you gotta have a nasty crossface for this move. Just bops him right there with the crossface. Then hand in the legs, and this is important. Hand in the legs, and a lot of guys, they just wanna move one hand towards the legs to lock it up. You gotta make sure you're using both hands, and that's gonna be the easiest and the best way to do this move. So it has both hands towards, and then from there, has it locked up. Got a jump sides to finish, so jump sides right there. And then finally right there, as you see, this time he steps up actually. I don't think I said it the first time, but stepping up is important, especially if you're gonna rock them back, if there is space. So he steps up, that's gonna get him the momentum to just rock him straight backwards. And as Caden Henschel once said, that is a flat man. Head in the temple, kicking up with his legs, and that's gonna be like a pin 90% of the time, especially if you are finishing like that, kicking up the leg and head in the temple. But yeah, that's gonna wrap up this video. Four steps, I guess, for this cradle is hard crossface, pry the crossface, hand between the legs, walk them together, lock up, and then jump sides, and then you just finish. And there are other finishes like suicide roll through. There's also, you can rock them sideways and a bunch of finishes like that. We can do that in future videos if you guys are interested. But yeah, that'll wrap up this video. If you enjoyed, make sure you leave a like, comment down below, and sub for more content like this. Peace.